I find that it helps me to break these down, so I'm going to start with just imagining printing the first row. This for loop might seem a little bit silly, but once I write it, I can compare it to the one for the second row. For each column, I want to print out a pair of square brackets. But in this case, the columns start at the first column and only go up to the first column, so that'll look like this. The for loop for the second row will look pretty similar, except it'll print two pairs of brackets, one for column one, one for column two. So this is interesting. Instead of something changing inside the loop, it's the actual loop condition itself that's changing from row to row. The threshold is actually the row itself. Now these are exactly the same. So I could set row to one and do this, and then increment row to two and do the exact same thing, which means that I can put this code into a loop. So I'll indent it, remove the extra repetitions, and now instead of just setting row to one, I'll actually loop over all of the rows, starting at one and going while row is less than or equal to the total number of rows. Let's see how much progress we've made after fixing typos. Well, it's certainly printing some brackets. Let's put line breaks between the rows. Much better. This was kind of neat. In this problem, we used the outer loop variable to control the number of iterations in the inner loop. The loop condition for the inner loop depends on the loop counter variable for the outer loop.